Hey, welcome back to more Dying Light 2! So, I'm playing this game again because, well, currently I'm in the middle of playing the DLC, Bloody Ties, but also, I just found out this morning when I woke up that apparently, Techland has added a brand new questline in this game, and I've been trying to make it work, but for some reason not popping up. So, what I've been trying to do is I'm trying to restart the game, I'm restarting my console, I'm doing everything I can to make sure this game is as fresh as possible, or updated, I'm not sure, but let's see if the mission actually pops up this time. So the way to find it is you have to go to the PK mission board, and it should show up as a missing person poster. No, there it is. Finally. Yeah, I've been trying for 20 minutes to get this pop up. Missing person. Our guy Michael went to St. Paul Island to investigate recent reports of a new zombie mutation. He has returned. We fear the worst. If you're ever brave enough to trace his steps and find out what happened, your courage will be rewarded. Now, slight spoiler, pretty much this questline is about Dying Light 1 characters, Tolga and Fatin. They're like these crazed genius inventors that are twins, brother, and pretty much they come back in this game in this form of a quest. I'm not sure for how long. I don't know what the quest entails itself, but all I know is that it's about them, so can't wait to see what it's about.
St. Paul Island. This Michael guy might have bitten off more than he can chew.
It wouldn't be the first time. He's a leap before you look kind of guy.
And I'm guessing you wrote this?
I did. Sarah.
I'm Aiden. Has he been gone long?
2 days now. He hasn't checked in on the radio. It's not like him. He's a little reckless, but not stupid. Something's happened to him.
And you two are close, I take it.
Not like that, but yeah, we go back. So I worry.
Sure. He went to St. Paul Island? Well, I can try to find him.
Thank you. I'll contact you if I hear anything.
The following quest contains sequence that includes flashing lights and or patterns. That's weird. The first time we've seen that in Dying Light 2. Just like in the middle of the quest. Leap before you look. Find Michael. Where's St. Paul Island? I don't know the map at the back of my head. It is over here. Okay, so it's pretty much like the end game area. Or I think that's down here. Never mind. Yeah, down here is the end game. Never mind. I was thinking about somewhere else. This is red, so it's like the Renegade area. I've never 100% completed this game, so is there any way to, like, dispose of, like, all the Renegades and just make sure that there's less of them? I'm not sure that's possible because, you know, there's always going to be enemies to fight. So, yeah, Tolga and Fatin comes back in this quest, and I just really wonder what's their role. What are they going to do? Are they going to stay around long after the quest, or not at all? I kind of hope they stick around. Even though they're kind of annoying characters the first game, kind of miss them. Also, it really sucks that they're pretty much coming back to this apocalypse after surviving the first time around. And they're like, what? It's like a 30-year gap between the last game and this game? It's like a long time jump, too. So they gotta be really old. Gray hair and all. And set objective area. Oh, I was in the... Oh, no. Okay, so I'm supposed to look for something. How big is the area? Great, it's gonna be nighttime soon. Gotta figure out where to go. What to look for. Oh, there's vault house now.
Looks recent. It could be Michael's. A map. Oh, marks a spot nearby. Maybe I can find some tracks.
Move, propane.
The radio's busted. Maybe that's why he didn't check in.
Back off. Back off.
Yeah.
Come on, anything else? In here? Oh, they saw me. God damn it.
Hello? Is anyone here?
Did I find something?
Michael? What's with the lights?
What the fuck?
Hello?
What is that a portal? Or is that like some sort of like just random light appearing out of nowhere? Touch. I guess the warning at the beginning of the mission makes sense now. Oh, it literally teleported me.
Where am I?
There's no map.
Sarah? Gosh, shit. Hello? Does anyone copy? Can anyone hear me? Great.
So, what am I doing down here? That's like a random metro. But it doesn't tell me on the map where I am, so I wonder if I'm still even in Villedor at all.
Hello?
You! Stay the fuck back! You're not getting me!
Hey, whoa, easy. Just looking for a guy called Michael.
Stay back! I know what you did. I know!
Me? Look, I just want to find this guy. A woman called Sarah wants him found.
Sarah? What are you... She's alive?
Of course she's alive. I can take you to her. If you're Michael.
Oh no. It's happening again.
What the hell is going on?
More rifts, the infection spreads. Is there really no end to it?
Well, I guess he's dead. What is going on here? Just gotta survive. My only objective. Take that. Gotta spawn camp. Keep coming. I dare you. Send more. Enter the teleporter. Where now?
Where the hell?
Yes, yes. Interdimensional rifts. That's obviously what they are.
It's not obvious. These rifts could be intradimensional or temporal. You are always jumping to conclusions.
It's getting weirder and weirder.
How dare you? The data is conclusive. They are conduits between dimensions. Doorways, if you will.
This is all highly hypothetical. We couldn't possibly confirm any of this without somebody foolish enough to risk exploring them.
Foolish like Aiden? Dude, that's totally Tolga and Fatin. I recognize their accent.
What the fuck?
Fatin, some kind of perpetually confused vagrant has wandered in through the rift. Get rid of him at once.
Let's not be too hasty, Tolga. He has functional limbs and presumably has mastered object permanence. He could be useful. What's your name, friend?
My name's Aiden. Where the hell am I? Who are you?
I am Tolga, and this is my brother Fatin. Now explain how and why you invaded our workshop.
Yes, you must have knowledge of these rifts. Stop gawking and tell us what you know.
I don't know. I was fighting the infected, and then some kind of light appeared. Looked a lot like that, actually.
This should not be happening. You! Is this your doing?
We need more data about this phenomenon. Fatin, you should examine it.
You should examine it. I'll provide support.
It's not hurting me. And if it brought me here, maybe
hey, don't touch it!
What oh, shit. Hell? Well, I'm back home, I guess. I wonder where they're located, what they're doing, and how they found out about these rifts.
Aiden, are you out there? It's Tolga.
Huh? So you two are real.
Of course we're real. This is no time for metaphysics. Our workshop is in the Office Plaza, Horseshoe District. Return to us at once. We must discuss the implications of what just happened.
All right. At this point, I'm curious enough. I'll be right over.
And this time, use the door like a normal person. Be polite, like us.
Maybe even wipe your feet. Pretend you live in a society.
Yeah. Society is a construct. It's just rules for the gullible.
Precisely. That's why he's a part of it, and we're not.
Right. Like, they're kind enough. Let's see if we can just fast travel over there, because that's very far away. Oh, I went a little too high. Damn it. Where are they? Real quick, and there is nothing.
All right, now let's try this again. What's going on, fellas?
We are obviously dealing with an interdimensional breach scenario. These topological distortions are becoming increasingly frequent.
Oh, Tolga, look at him. He won't know what that means. He's a simple soul in need of guidance. Explain it in his own language.
Yes, of course, you're right. Now, Aiden, imagine you are in your happy place. A slightly urine-soaked cardboard box in some filthy alleyway, perhaps. To you, it seems like a mansion. Yes?
You two must get punched a lot.
Now, that box is your whole world. But outside of it, there are many other things. And one day, somebody punches a hole through the wall of your box.
As the sunlight blinds you, you gibber in confusion because you have never seen it before. All you know is the box and its comforting smells. You cannot cope.
And as you cower in fear, unable to deal with the implications of what is happening, new holes appear. To your primitive brain, This is terrifying.
All right, yeah, I get it. Holes bad. Get to the point.
We need to investigate further. That's why we've prepared these spectral goggles.
They will let you see the rifts. As a bonus, they will also obscure your features, something the rest of us will appreciate. Beyond that, all you need to do is use your core skill.
Meaning?
You need to touch things.
That's it? Just touch the anomalies?
See? I told you he would be perfect for the job. So adaptive.
Look, the last time I touched one of those things, I almost turned into a stain on a sidewalk.
And yet, here you are, except without the data we need. Next time, you'll be better prepared.
You're welcome. Now go stick your fingers into things until something interesting happens. Get us that data. Meanwhile, some of us have real work to do.
All right, just gotta go touch a bunch of holes. Nothing abnormally for me. Anomalies. Equip the spectral goggles and investigate the anomalies. Then place your player stash. So it's not my inventory? There it is. Increase the perception range of the rift marker indicator. Model number. Invented at TFL. Oh, it's a whole item set. Whoa. Oh. Okay. Gotcha. Wow, it gets a lot bigger when you get closer up.
Okay, fellas. I'm at a rift. You sure this is safe?
Define safe. Is it as safe as jumping off a rooftop? Is it as safe as facing an army of infected with a sharp stick? You'll probably be fine.
I wish there was like a button like the flashlight to just turn it on off the goggles, so it'll be easier to turn off the filter. Whoa, what's going on? It's all dark now.
What the?
This feels trippy. It feels all slow motion. Am I just walking? Wakanda forever.
Aiden, Fatin, he's back. Cancel plan B. Did you learn anything during your trip, Aiden?
Things get weird out there. Very weird. Let's just leave it at that.
Yeah, it gets all gray in slow motion. I wonder if this has any lasting effects on Aiden, because he's the one touching all these holes. Oh, I finally found it. Thank God. Touch it. Touch the hole, Aiden. Underwater? What? Oh, okay. Am I in the sewers now? Gotta go look for more holes. That's my special ability. Where am I? All this looks totally new to me. The architectural structure kind of reminds me of Haran. Wait, is everything upside down? What the hell? It looks upside down. This is so weird. Everything about this questline is so weird. Must touch hole. And that's it. Gotta leave. This Voltel's here. Where's the exit? I lost the exit.
Of course it's me.
Oh, I died. Dude, my game's broken. Why are there Voltels in the daytime? Wait a minute. What is going on here? What? In the bottom corner, it shows the moon. It's supposed to be nighttime. Why is it so bright? Okay, either it has something to do with the quest, or my game is just buggy as hell right now. Because Voltels are not supposed to be out right now. I was trying to make it nighttime so it's easier to see with the special goggles. But I guess it doesn't matter. Well, that sucks. Alright, anomaly number 3. Let me touch hole. No! Almost got me there. Oh, fuck. The transformation scared the hell out of me. I haven't done this in a while. You know, it really does suck. This transformation is not like an ultimate move you can do in this game. You know, that can charge up and use once in a while. It would be kind of nice. Kill them all! Buh. Was that a zombie or a person? Oh, it's a person. Is that Michael? Wait, did I just kill Michael? It looked like the same NPC model for Michael. Okay, now this time it shows it's daylight.
Tolga, Fatin, you there?
Speak.
These other realities, are they really real or just some kind of, I don't know, illusions?
Of course they're real. Try to keep your confusion from hampering our progress.
Tolga, you have to be gentle with him. You know he yearns for your approval. He's much like a puppy. All the literature says that rewarding correct behavior gets better results than punishment.
I suppose you're right. What do you think he would find rewarding?
I was holding B, that means I should be able to do a roll and not die. What the hell happened? Is it not in the water? Oh, is that right there? Hold on. Yeah, there it is. Where to now? I'm tiny. So apparently in this reality, everything is much more bigger than me. Is that it? That was a quick one.
Aiden, this is Tolga. Come in.
Go ahead, Tolga.
When you travel through the rifts, what do you see? Please be precise.
Flashes of light? Nothing specific. It's more what I feel. A wrenching sensation? And like, for an instant, somebody near me. That was hard to explain, but it's a powerful feeling.
The third man factor, perhaps.
Sorry, what?
It's a neurological thing. Your body and your brain are constantly talking. If those signals get scrambled, your brain can misinterpret your body's location slightly. So the sensation of another person there is, in fact, you sensing yourself.
I blew up.
Doing it from outside.
That's a real thing?
Yes. Or it could be a symptom of significant brain damage. But in your case, how could we really tell?
Yeah, okay. I think we're done here.
How do I get up there? I think I gotta go all the way around and then climb a wall and get on top. Okay, now where am I? Looks like limbo. What? Quest failed. You got stuck in a multiversal space-time quantum paradox. Well, apparently I wasn't supposed to go that way. What about this way? There you go. Can I make that? Of course I can. I'm Aiden. What? Don't down. Aiden, you're supposed to grab onto those automatically. Found your hole. Hole number 5 out of 6. One left to go. What's that alarm hearing? That sounds new. Found the last hole. So far this quest, I don't know. It's not that great so far. I kind of don't like having to run around the entire map looking for these anomalies. Would it be nice if it was only like 3, but 6? A little bit too much. Oh god, I should not be here. Chemicals. That. Ow. You do a lot of damage. Well, so can I. Who's next? That's it? Oh, only one little boss? No big deal.
Aiden, you can stop playing around with the rifts. We have all the data we can use.
Are you sure? I think I'm kind of good at this.
Everyone should experience something new once in their lives.
Come back to the workshop. We have a new plan.
Inhibitor, where is it? Inhibitor nearby. How? That was so far away. And I made it. Perfect landing.
I'm back. Are we any closer to figuring this out?
Of course, of course. We now know that these rifts are not just random occurrences. They're doorways, Aiden. Doorways that lead to other dimensions.
So your little escapade was a jaunt along the edges of our reality. But it's not a pleasure cruise. Unless we secure these doorways, there is a definite danger of our universe collapsing completely.
I'm just gonna assume you know what you're doing. How do we fix this?
Why? We close the rifts and secure our reality. For that, we need some special technology. Fortunately, it turns out that we have already completed the design phase.
We have drawn up the plans, but this is where things get complicated. The plans are in a cave, on the drafting table there. We know that cave, but we don't know which cave it is, precisely.
Or which iteration of Tolga and Fatin drew up those plans.
So, by you, you mean other versions of you in other dimensions?
It's complicated. Don't worry about it.
I've seen something like that already. There was this guy, Michael. He was missing, and I was...
Yes, yes. That cuts down on the need for explanations. You will need these gloves. They'll allow you to move through the rifts without... well, without random space shifts.
All right, now give me the part that's gonna suck.
Well, the cave, the target location is somewhat uncertain. It might require some zeroing in.
Oh, he'll be fine. He'll get us our plans and stitch together the fabric of reality. Or we'll all die in uncomprehending agony as reality collapses around us.
Just get us those plans. Let us do the thinking.
No pressure, huh?
So am I just supposed to go look for a bunch of caves, or is there like one singular cave in this map somewhere? Oh, there's an anomaly thing right there. Retrieve the blueprint from the cave. By the way, I was given gloves. Can I wear those gloves, or are they not equipable yet? Spatial stabilization gloves. Under laboratory conditions, these gloves allow for increased control over the transspatial fluctuations. Okay. I like the design. It's all blue. Fortunately, that's my favorite color, so I can't wait to see what the whole entire set looks like. Don't stop, we're on a mission, I'll retire, I'll run the competition, Kenny, up to Tally when it's done. What comes around? Comes back around. Oh, the chemicals. Oh, man. Oh, it's a cave, right, so I have to look for underneath, not on top. Unless, wait, is there a hole anywhere in the surface here, or do I literally have to go underneath somewhere? Nope, okay, the bed, yep. 10 seconds left. Gotta leave. Okay, great. So, I know it's there. I just need to find out where the actual entrance is. Is there one inside the mountain here somewhere? Inside a tunnel where the streets are? It is really hard to see daylight with these goggles on. I feel I should probably take them off since I already know the general area. Be a lot more easier. Hold on, what's this? Oh, here we go. Found something. Retrieve the blueprint from the cave. Oh, whoa, chemicals. I found a random cannon. Okay, that's cool. What the hell is that? I think I found it. Stabilize the rift using gloves from Tolga and Fatin. How do I do that? Wait, hold on. Do I have to wear the goggles too or just the gloves? Okay, it doesn't matter. Okay, I get it now. Am I doing it right? Come on, get off. Jesus. There's one. Was that a bomber? I heard a gurgling. Number three. Well, I found the cave. Gotta take off my mask again because I don't like the way it looks. What, you're still here? Which one do I take? I'm guessing that was the wrong one. This is a Voltal's nest. What am I doing here? There, got rid of.
Okay, so where is this place?
Mia!
The Waltz. What do you need me to do next?
The infection must not
what
spread!
What now? Am I stuck in my own head?
No! Come on, we have to meet the others.
Waltz, got a problem.
There are rifts opening everywhere. The infected are pouring through.
And whatever this place is, the plans aren't here.
Dad? I'll be there shortly. Mia's coming too.
The PKs are finished. The city is yours. The only thing that matters is stopping that virus from spreading.
Dad? PKs? City's yours? Is that like an alternate Aiden that's like a bad guy? That's working for Waltz? Well, are there really good and bad guys in like Apocalypse? It's more like perspectives. In my perspective, Waltz is a bad guy. I gotta go for this one. What if I made an alternate Aiden? How cool would that be? I mean, it's not impossible, but like, will they actually do it?
Gotcha.
How nice would it be if one of these portals actually took you to Iran for a little bit? A little bit of fan service. Chemicals, chemicals, chemicals!
Found the plants. This should make the twins happy.
Now go back to your office.
Well, I stole the plants from your evil twins. We're good twins. I don't know.
I wouldn't overthink it.
Let's see them!
Enjoy.
Incredible. This surpasses even our most optimistic predictions.
Our genius shines brightly in all possible realities.
Look at the penmanship.
Just as exquisite as ours.
So, what's the next step?
Now, we build. These plans hold the solution to our little anomaly crisis.
Side quest completed. Anomalies. I got pants. New side quest. The machine. God damn, it's a lot more long than I thought it was gonna be. Let the anthropic locator. What? Alright, the machine. Let the anthropic locator boots lead you to machine components within rifts. Find a dimensional crystal. Find the quantum core. Find the ethereal processor. Find the reality stabilizer plate. Find the anti-gravitational modulators. Find the temporal glass. Well, guess I better start looking. Let me guess, I need my goggles to find it. My special gaggles? Yep, there they are. You know what? I'm just gonna probably cut all this out since pretty much I'm going throughout the entire map again and looking for a bunch of stuff 6 times again. So I'll be right back. All right, here we go. I collected all 6 items. It was such a hassle. I didn't like it at all. But I'm now done, so finally, let's continue.
No doubt that this will work flawlessly, Fatin.
Absolutely, Tolga. With a few unexpected side effects, of course.
So?
Tolga, did you open that?
No. This is unexpected. Step away from the machine!
What the hell? Is that another version of me?
Another Aiden? Look, we don't have the time to babysit two incompetents. Stand aside! We...
Fatin, no!
I'm sorry. I can't allow you to do this. Too much is at stake.
Fatin, come on. He's gone. It's over. You can get up now.
Tolga. Tolga, come on. He's...
You think I don't know? You find him. You kill him.
Kill myself? This is insane.
Your double, wherever he comes from, wants to keep us from fixing the anomalies. That means he is behind them. He is making our reality collapse.
And how do I find him? Me. This version of me.
Now he has the machine. I can track it. And by extension, him. So you hunt him down. You kill him. You bring the machine back. I fix everything. Is this too complicated for you?
Tolga. About Fatin.
No. We are working now. These will let you stabilize the anomalies. You have to locate three anomalies and move them to exactly where I say. Once you have done that, a rift will open to where the machine is. Look for the anomalies in the downtown area. I'll contact you later with the coordinates for where to place them. Now go. I need to do something.
Oh, he's dead now? Well, that sucks. Well, at least I got a jack out of that. Follow the white rabbit. Align anomalies with Toga's bracers and open a rift. Oh, great. Three more locations. Well, at least this time, they're like all close to each other. And I don't have to go to the other side of the map for this one.
Heavier than it looks.
Okay, that was one. Align anomalies with Tolga's bracers and open the rift. Okay, well, I feel kind of dumb. The last few minutes, I was trying to go to these anomalies and interact with them, but I couldn't. And this whole time, I found out you had to put on bracers that he gave you, and not the gloves. This whole time, I thought it was just the gloves. How do I get up there? What is the quickest way? Oh, shit. That's not good. I'm gonna die. Grab the slots. Come on. You can do it, Aiden. Number one.
I have the first anomaly situated.
Readings are stable. Get the next one.
Tolga, we've got the anomaly. I don't like the way this thing feels.
You have to be quick. It won't stay stable for long. Hurry!
Keep it together, Aiden.
God damn it! Jump off! Okay, sort of save myself. Where am I going? I can barely see with the filter on. over there. Hold on. Where is it? Oh god, I almost turned around. Hold on. So close.
I'm at the location. Looking for the spot now.
Be careful. We cannot afford
Second anomaly set. No fireworks, so...
The gloves work as intended. Fatin always does good work. Get the last anomaly, Aiden. Your miserable existence relies on it.
All right, last one. Not a great start. Really big shortcut here.
Hurry, Aiden. We still have a chance to stop your doppelganger. That's worth a little sweat. Huh?
Okay, what's next? There we go, that's a big boost.
Almost there.
No! Grapple! Oh, there we go. I almost died.
Rift's opening.
Yes, I see the light in the sky. We won't have comms while you're in there, so you're on your own. Remember, kill yourself, get the machine, bring it back. Understand?
I hear you. I'll see you soon.
All right, time to go fight evil Aiden, I guess.
Kill yourself. Right. Here goes.
I wonder how the fight's gonna be like. It's probably gonna be like a normal human enemy, but just a lot more dodgier. A lot more powerful with attacks.
never an easy thing seeing one of you. It's not like looking in the mirror. It's the same, but not the same. Yeah, it just feels wrong, you know? Yeah, it's weird. It's creepy. For what it's worth, and I know it's not much, I am sorry you have to go through this. It's not you. It's the infection. I'm just trying to keep it from spreading. By destroying an entire universe. But the thing is, your universe doesn't just stay in your universe. It pokes through reality's weak points. You've seen things coming through, right? So, there's a nice, clean, non-infected universe over there. And then here's your sick, virus-laden universe. All it takes is one rift, one little incursion, and you've got a patient zero over there. Boom. Scratch off the planet. Ah, shit. Even you're infected in this universe. Maybe you'll be the patient zero somewhere else. Yeah, okay, I get that. I do. But Tolga's machine's gonna fix it. Make it so nothing comes in or out. You don't have to do this. Would you gamble an entire universe, countless universes, on that hope? No. You deal with the infection by eradicating it. So you just murder everybody in an entire universe just like that? Your Earth has, what, thousands? A few million people left alive, tops? A planet without infection has billions. Listen, I know it's awful. I know. But you've seen what the infection does. We can keep it from spreading. Look at the big picture. Let go of your diseased reality and save billions like it. This anomaly, we make it unstable and this infected universe is gone. All it takes is a bit of kinetic energy aimed at the right point, and a chain reaction will collapse it completely. One hit, one strike, and all those other universes are safer.
There has to be another way.
Not that I can see. So what are you gonna choose? Hope or certainty?
Oh, we get to choose. 30 seconds, I could side with you, but I kind of want to fight you. And the only way to do that, I have to be against you. So, sorry?
Tolga said you have to die. Until right now, I wasn't so sure. I know. Those hard calls get a lot easier when you get some perspective, huh?
Are they all other Aidens from other universes now? Here, take off the mask. I don't need it anymore.
This is madness!
Come on, I dare you. Fight me. Nope. Guys, done fucked up. You're not gonna win.
Yeah.
Any more? They keep coming. Is there like an infinite amount of Aidens? I mean, there's like infinite universes, fictionally, but still. How many more do they have to fight? That's it? They're all dead? Pick up the stolen piece of the machine. Yeah, and that's it.
You talked about the infection. But how many people did you kill with these anomalies? Well, Tolga, I guess we saved everyone. I'm coming home.
So that's it?
What the? Hello? Anyone here?
Fatin, some kind of perpetually confused vagrant has wandered in through the rift.
Side quest completed. Follow the white rabbit. That's it. See you in. Aiden, if you're reading this, it means several things. First, you stopped yourself and saved your reality from destruction. Or, possibly, your other self was too incompetent to follow through on his plan. We all will be charitable and assume that you accomplished something. Bravo. Secondly, we had no opportunity to say goodbye. This letter will have to suffice. Thirdly, it means that you can read, which is not something we would take for granted. Perhaps you are staring at these words with dull, uncomprehending eyes. But again, you will receive the benefit of doubt and will assume you are literal. Look at it. Look at you operating the outer edge of your capabilities. Be proud. TNF. PS. Keep the gear. Might come in handy. Okay. Well, is that it? That's the entire quest? Well, kind of disappointed. Suffice to say. Also, the note says TNF as if both were running to me, even though one of them has died. Presumably, he's dead. He got two gunshots in the chest, it seems like. But yeah, that's it. Wow. Now, before I end the video, real quick, I want to look up the playthrough of this quest, see if someone else already posted it, and see what they chose for their ending. And I want to see what the other side is, like the other choice, if they've chose that one. I think I might have found it. Okay, this is by the YouTuber Top Chop, and he's pretty much going through this entire quest line. And there's not a lot of videos talking about this because it's a brand new quest and I'm playing it as it just came out. So this is like the first video that pops up when you look up the quest on YouTube.
Original reality or disagree with him. I ended up agreeing with him just to see what happens, and I'll let that play out so you can take a look for yourselves.
I can't believe I'm saying this, but you're right. Maybe I'll go to hell for this, but it's gotta be worth it if it keeps the virus from spreading.
You've been in hell your entire life, Aiden. But this way, you stop that hell from spreading.
Oh. Okay, well, this choice, when you join with him, it actually plays a credit sequence. A heartfelt thank you to all the players. We hope you enjoyed this gaming experience. Oh, that's cool. Well, it means different, but what happens afterwards?
They really went quite out there with...
Oh, that's it? So if you join him, he punches the portal, and I guess it collapses your universe, your reality, and then the credits play. If you don't join him, you have this really cool sequence. You fight a bunch of Aiden doppelgangers, and you go back to your reality, and you get a letter. Okay. Shout out to Top Chop, because this is like the only video I found for Tolga and Fatin about this, because literally it's a brand new quest, and I've seen no other video about this. There's videos of people talking about it, but no like playthroughs of it. I don't know, maybe the people playing on Twitch right now are streaming it. So that's going to be it for the Tolga and Fatin questline in Dying Light 2. It was very cool to see them come back, but it kind of sucked that one of them had to die in the story. All in all, not a big fan of it. It was just super annoying having to travel around the entire map multiple times with the anomalies, but it was sort of worth it just to kill a bunch of aliens in the end. Good end here. Like the video, enjoy watching, subscribe more content like this, and I'll see you next time when I post next. Bye!